Welcome to this week's Quick Charge. Last week, we learned that whatever has my attention has open access to all of me. But also consider that whatever has my attention has me. So if God has my attention, He has me. Because whatever has my attention has me. Remember that John instinctively bowed down to what had his attention. It received his honor and his worship, and it became first to him. When he turned his attention away from the throne of God and toward an angel of God, it wasn't that long before he was worshiping that angel instead of God. In the days of Daniel, that image of gold made by the king wasn't some rusty relic. It was shiny and attractive and eye-catching and inspiring. And as soon as it was set up, it became an object of honor and worship. The sons of Israel, however, refused to give attention to that captivating image. But even the king's fiery furnace couldn't harm them because he didn't have them. God did. Cornelius in Acts chapter 10 is praying and seeking God when an angel appears and instructs him, send for Peter. Now Cornelius was worshiping God until he sees Peter. Then his attention turns and he starts worshiping Peter in a split second, just like John. Notice, these are not evil people attending to evil things. Peter is a righteous, godly, faithful man, but he doesn't merit Cornelius's worship. The angels were faithful servants. They had been proven as part of the two-thirds that didn't forsake God when given the opportunity. It's the same as our gifting, our anointing, our ministry, our talents, and charisma. It doesn't deserve our full attention. We can't serve both. I can't pay attention to the provision and the provider, the supply and the supplier, the gift and the giver. Jesus said in Matthew 4:10, go away from me, Satan. It is written in the scriptures, you must worship the Lord your God. Serve only him. Notice, worshiping God is not enough. I must attend to or put my attention on him only. The Bible says in 1 Kings 11:4, when Solomon was old, his wives turned his heart away from other gods, and his heart was not completely devoted to the Lord his God. He tried to divide his attention. So the message of Daniel and John and Cornelius and Jesus is all the same. You can't share or divide your attention, even with good things. It must be undivided. You can't put your attention on anything else, no matter how deserving or attractive or worthy it might be or seem. Because what has my attention has me. It has my honor. And it will always be first, front and center, in lieu of Jesus. In the film Raiders of the Lost Ark, the glory of God begins to emanate from the freshly opened ark. And Belloc, the archaeologist, cries out, it's beautiful. His attention has been taken by the brilliance and ultimately his life as well. But Indiana Jones says to Marion, don't look at it. Don't look at the special effects. Keep your eyes shut. Keep your attention undivided. Don't get distracted. Why? Because whatever has my primary attention will have me. It will be first in me and first with me. It will be at the forefront always. Does Jesus have your undivided attention? Join me next week for more of So What Are You Looking At? God bless.